Hi, I'm Steve Reeser, a fisheries biologist with the Virginia Department of Game and Inland Fisheries. And today we're here on a very soggy day in early September. I want to share a little bit of a collaborative project with you between our agency and Trout Unlimited and the U.S. Forest Service, where we're going to reintroduce brook trout to a stream where they were extirpated years ago. And so part of that is we went to two streams that have current wild resident populations of brook trout, electroshocked them to collect them, different age classes of those fish, and we've moved them about 15 miles north on the Massanutten Mountain to this to Upper Passage Creek here in Shenandoah County. So to collect these fish today, we're going to use electricity. We momentarily stun each fish before we relocate them. We take a length and a weight of each brook trout, and then also a small snippet of caudal fin or tail fin, and that's going to be used for genetic analysis for future research for this project.
I'm Dawn Kirk, the Forest Fisheries Biologist for the George Washington and Jefferson National Forest. And part of the Forest Service mission is to restore and protect habitat for native species. And this project is looking specifically at wild brook trout. So this project was funded through the Forest Stamp program. And Forest Stamp is a license that hunters and anglers purchase through the state, and the money goes directly to National Forest Habitat Management.
One of the reasons we're out here on Passage Creek is when we started the Home Rivers Initiative for Trout Unlimited, you know, our main focus with Trout Unlimited is to restore, protect, and enhance native habitat for native trout, in this case, brook trout in Virginia. And so when we looked at this Passage Creek watershed, the watershed conditions, the forested riparian buffer, the trees here, the canopy cover, all said brook trouts would be here, but we didn't find them. So we started looking at some more specifics of habitat quality, water quality, and determined brook trout should be in this section of Passage Creek, but weren't. So we started the process of improving the habitat by adding some log structures to make bigger pools and deeper pools. We also had a barrier that prevented fish from moving upstream and downstream, a small concrete dam, which we removed and stabilized the area around that dam. And by doing that, we improved the habitat to the point where we were able to reintroduce brook trout to this stream. So moving forward, we're going to continue to monitor the stream, see if the brook trout we've put in here can reproduce and spawn and establish a population.